Contemporary songs are very popular among Cambodians nowadays, but most of them are not really originally composed. This lack of originality may have its roots back in the dark years of the Khmer Rouge regime. To investigate this, let's start by taking a look at Khmer contemporary musics of the 1960s and 70s before the regime. Thousands of songs were written and strongly supported by audiences. There were many talented and creative musicians and artistic singers. The music scene in Cambodia developed dramatically. El Buna, a song composer since the 1960s, remembers.
We compose new music. Writers express their emotions and imagination in the lyrics, describe the views in the provinces and love in the society and family. We wrote it without copying from others.
It all changed on April 17, 1975, when the Khmer Rouge came to power. Most of Cambodia, including its thriving music industry, changed completely.
Khmer Rouge devastated everything. Not only did we lose music itself, but many experienced musicians were also killed.
Songs that were appreciated until then all of a sudden were considered immoral and capitalistic. Instead, the Khmer Rouge produced its own revolutionary songs.
Those songs created at that period mostly narrated agricultural productions and the construction of railroads, dams, and reservoirs. The songs forced people to think only about working and yielding. There was nothing to make people feel relaxed. They just made people work relentlessly.
Picking up the pieces after the collapse of the regime wasn't easy. Sen Chan Saya, director of the Department of Cinema and Cultural Diffusion, explains the effects of Khmer Rouge on the rebirth of recent music industry after the war.
The best consequence after Pol Pot regime for the Khmer music was that the loss of knowledgeable, experienced and talented music composers and songwriters. When we lost those people, it means we lost teachers. So who can students learn from? We are lacking human resources in the music industry.
In 1989, the Cambodian government reopened the School of Fine Arts and Royal University of Fine Arts to provide classes in art, including music, with the aim to reproduce human resources in the new generation. When it comes to, quote, taking inspiration from other composers, independent music researcher Seng Dara says that in the past, only part of the music here was copied from foreign music. Nowadays, a great amount is copied from foreign sources. Mr. Dara also points out the differences between composers in the 1960s and composers today.
In the past, songs were about love and emotions with the description of natural views and tradition in that generation. Most of the current songs, those have only simple meanings, no metaphors, and mostly they are all about love using modern words and only serve the people in the city.
Elbanasan Numbonorot, a music composer and contemporary singer, graduated from Royal University of Fine Arts in Music with a bachelor's degree. He praises the songs produced in his father's period. He says those songs created strong emotions and imagination, not like the songs today.
Music productions in the country mostly come up with songs about young love, crossing loves, and broken-hearted love. There is nothing we can imagine from the songs like those in the past.
Many recent songs receive only short-term popularity and support because too many are created just by copying from foreign songs. Since he started his career in 2004, Numbonorot has produced only 10 original music songs, like 1 minute, but that got strong support. As one cause for this, he named some profound challenges that make original music composing nowadays so difficult.
Musicians spend much time to write an original music note, so the price of it had to be twice higher than the copy ones. What is more challenging is that production owners do not have willing to buy the new and original songs because the expensive songs will not help them survive in the market that is full of copy songs.
Sen Chan Saya says that the government strengthened intellectual property rights with laws created in 2003. That was meant to improve the quality of songs and boost the music industry in the company.
When we can protect the rights of composers, they will get more profit, and this will improve the quality of songs. Nowadays, they compose many songs to gain profit because songs are cheap. Therefore, the more songs they produce in the market, the more profit they get.
Taking all this into account, the devastating effects of the Khmer Rouge regime with its loss of human resources may only be part of the puzzle for the lack of originality in Khmer music today. There are other pieces. Stronger enforcement of copyright laws would help, more incentives for creative minds to step forward, and even more importantly, audiences willing to pay for what they get.